Well, it's going to take a toll watching someone you love struggling to cope. One in five Australians will experience depression at some stage in their lives. And when they do, most of them will require support from a family member or a carer. But how does this impact on the health of the carers themselves? Well, new research shows we could be looking at a potential mental health crisis. 2.6 million people care for someone living with a mental illness. That is 12% of the population. Now, 70% of these carers live with psychological stress that is an immediate risk to their own well-being. While the government is spending billions of dollars on those already ill, far too little is spent on assisting those who help them. Now, the one person who suffered from a mental health illness was former New South Wales opposition leader John Brogden. He tried to take his own life in his electoral office after quitting as the opposition leader 8 years ago. But he has turned his life around and is now the CEO of the Financial Services Council and is the national patron for Lifeline. His wife, Lucy, stood by his side throughout his ordeal. Joining me now is Lucy Brogden, a patron of Partners in Depression. Lucy, good evening. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Matt.
The figures here really are quite staggering. More than 2.5 million Australians who are caring for someone with a mental illness. Just how significant are the emotional challenges for those carers?
Well, Matt, we know that depression itself isn't contagious, but what we do know is that people that live and care for someone with a mood disorder are at risk of developing that themselves. And the research that we've launched just this week highlights the fact that more than 70% of the people coming as carers to our program are reporting high levels of distress themselves.
High levels of distress, and that obviously it means they're prone to depression and those sorts of mental illnesses.
Anxiety, those sorts of things, yeah.
You have extensive experience in this area yourself, Lucy. You were a carer for your husband during a difficult time. John Brogden, the former New South Wales opposition leader. How difficult was that experience for you?
Matt, I think my experience, as public as it was, is not that different to most people in the caring role. I knew for many years before John was diagnosed that he wasn't well. He wasn't a happy person. He was putting on a brave face, going off to work every day, but the person that I knew and loved had changed and was no longer enjoying life the way I knew he could. I did a lot of the things that most carers do, tried to show him rationally that he was depressed, but like most young men, he saw himself as invincible. So for us, actually, the crisis that came to us was a blessing in disguise, because once he got the diagnosis of depression, we were actually on a path to recovery.
Well, you see, the report from the Hunter Institute describes these carers as the hidden heroes of Australia's health system, which is a really lovely way of putting it. How exactly would these preventative programs work? How would they benefit?
Well, what we found in terms of the research that we've just done and that we're launching is that we can actually improve the well-being of the carers themselves, which is a great first step. It also improves their ability to care for the person, gives them an understanding of that. That was one of the first things that people said they were looking for, is just information. They understand and learn how to talk about suicide, which tragically is related to the depression illness. But they also learn, and this is the most important part, is self-care. If you're not looking after yourself, physically and mentally, you can't be a good carer.
How much money do we spend? How much money should we spend on people who care for those people?
One of the things that we're really proud of nationally, I think, is that we've raised the issue of mental health, and we can now as a community generally talk about it a lot more openly than we once did. Governments of both persuasions are spending a lot more on the issues of mental health. We now have dedicated ministers for it, but it's been very much focused at the treatment end. And we're saying, let's now shift that focus and look at some prevention options. Our data shows that we could be saving the government about half the cost of looking after someone with a mood disorder just by putting them through a preventative program.
Well, Lucy Brogden, it's an important message, and we're grateful for you sharing it. Thanks for your time tonight.
Thank you, Matt.